কিন্তু এরকম হয় গ্রামে, তাতে কি তাতে কি হতে পারে? এই যে এয়ার পলিউশন, তার ইম্প্যাক্টটা দুটো জিনিসের উপর ডিপেন্ড করে, যেতে কনসেন্ট্রেশন কত, যেটা এই 40 মাইক্রোগ্রাম পার মিটার কিউব বা 60 মাইক্রোগ্রাম মিটার কিউব, আপনি যদি 24 ঘন্টা 7x24 তাকে ফেস করেন, তাহলে সেটাই যথেষ্ট আপনার নষ্ট করেন। কিন্তু সেখানে যদি 20-60 মাইক্রোগ্রামের জায়গায় 60 গ্রাম থাকে, সেখানে আপনি কয়েক সেকেন্ড সেটা ইনহেল করলেই আপনার একই অবস্থা। সেই জন্যে এত বেশি ইম্পর্টেন্ট। সেকেন্ড থিং উনি বললেন, অ্যাফেক্টেশন কি হয় এয়ার পলিউশনে, সবচেয়ে বেশি অ্যাফেক্টেড হয় 3টে ক্লাসের লোক, একটা হচ্ছে বাচ্চা, ভেরি ইয়াং, একটা হচ্ছে ভেরি ওল্ড, অ্যান্ড থার্ড ইজ মোস্ট ইম্পর্টেন্ট, নিউট্রিশনাল ডেফিসিয়েন্সি যাদের আছে তারা এয়ার পলিউশনে সবচেয়ে বেশি অ্যাফেক্টেড হয়। অর্থাৎ যারা গরিব, মানে 4টে স্কোয়ার মিল, 2টো স্কোয়ার মিল ভালো পায় না, তাদের এয়ার পলিউশন সবচেয়ে অ্যাফেক্ট করবে বেশি। লাস্ট পয়েন্ট যেটা উনি বললেন, যে জলটা ঠিক করে নিয়ে ফিল্টার করে খাওয়া যায়, তার থেকেও একটা বড় কথা আছে। ধরুন আপনি গেলেন অম্বোধপুরে খুব চেষ্টা পেল, জল দিল আপনাকে, জলটা আপনার পছন্দ হলো, আপনি বলতে পারেন যে ঠিক আছে আমি বিধাননগরে খুব ভালো জল পেয়েছিলাম, ওখানে গিয়ে জলটা খাবো, কারণ খাওয়া থেকে বলা যাবে যে আমি অম্বোধপুরের এয়ারটা খুব খারাপ, এখানে বিল করবো না, আগে বিধাননগরে পৌঁছে তারপর আমি নিঃশ্বাস নেবো। এইটা হচ্ছে তফাৎ এয়ার আর ওয়াটার। আর একটা জিনিস হচ্ছে, আমরা গোটা দিনে খাবার খাই অ্যাবাউট 1 কেজি পার ডে, রাফলি একবারে, এটা ভ্যারি করে। আমরা জল খাই অ্যাবাউট রাফলি 2 কেজি পার ডে, আমরা ব্রিথ করি 24 কেজি অফ এয়ার পার ডে। সো এয়ারের ইম্পর্টেন্স আর কবে বলে দিতে হবে, এয়ারের পলিউশনের ইম্পর্টেন্সটা কত। Thank you very much.
Jai Prakash Gupta, Director Technical, Eastern Coalfields Limited. Please address us, sir.
Dr. Kalyan Rudra, Chairman of West Bengal Pollution Control Board. Respectable Alok Mukherjee, former President, Bengal Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Participants from Bengal Chamber of Commerce and Industries, West Bengal, Pollution Control Boards, delegates, our friends from different industries. We all know that the concept of sustainable development was first defined in the World Commission on Environment and Development in the year 1987. However, the 65th session of United Nations General Assembly in 2010 gave a different dimension to this concept. The importance of the session lies in the fact that the United Nations Secretary General submitted a report that highlights the fact that around the world, ancient civilizations have a rich history of understanding the symbolic connection between human beings and the nature. With regards to the India, the report noted, the Vedic philosophy of India has always emphasized the human connection with the nature. The Vedism is a way of life, which were written by sages who lived in the forest. The Mahabharata, Ramayana, Vedas, Upanishads, Bhagavad Gita contains some of the earliest messages on the ecological balance, the need for the people, ethical treatment of the nature. They emphasize harmony with the nature and recognize that all natural elements hold divinity. It therefore follows that the human civilization has always thrived to maintain a balance between their own consumption pattern and regenerative capacity of the nature, so that the production consumption pattern is at par with the carrying capacity of the nature. However, as civilization developed, the need for natural resources has increased. This has stressed the already constrained natural resources, and the proper management of the natural resources has therefore become need of the hour. The rationale of the sustainable development is the management of the natural resources in a way that its utilization is at par with its reproductive capacity of the nature. As we all know, it rests on three pillars, that is, environmental protection, economic development, and the social development. However, the correlation between these three pillars is a bit different when Indian development scenario is taken into the consideration. It is well known fact that India is the highest growing major economy of the world as now. The GDP growth rate of the India is presently pegged at around 7 to 7.5%, which needs to be accelerated. The fruits of this economic development will trickle down so as to meet the development needs of the society. Be it poverty alleviation or housing infrastructure, the engineers of the economic growth will propel social development, and for all these, India needs sustained source of the energy. We all know that the coal is the principal source of energy for India. It is embarking on an ambitious target to achieve the renewable energy capacity of 175 gigawatt by 2022, and future of the coal as source of energy has been debated in length at various forums. However, the very fact that the coal will continue to be the primary source of energy cannot be denied. Presently, Indian thermal power plants requires around 800 million tonnes of coal, of which 650 million tonnes is produced by the India and the rest is being imported. The International Energy Agency has predicted in one of its reports that coal will retain a central position in the energy mix in India, and its overall share in energy will be 49% in the year 2040. In order to cope up with ever-increasing demand of coal, Coal India Limited has an ambitious target of producing 1 billion tonne of coal in the year by the year 2020-21. ECL is going to produce to the tune of 62 million tonne by the same time. Having said that, it is our mutual responsibility to ensure that mining activities are done in an environment-friendly manner, so that the third pillar of the sustainable development, that is environment protection, goes hand in hand with the economic and the social development, emancipating from the production of this principal source of energy, that is coal. It is pleasing that the ECL has taken initiatives to protect the environment. Every mine of the ECL has an exhaustive environment management plan and a mine closure plan with a special thrust on the sustainable development. To ensure sustainable green environment, massive afforestation bringing over land broken due to mining has been taken up. Till date, the company has done plantation over 3,100 hectares of land degraded by the mining. Also, other measures like scientific water management, artificial recharge, use of renewable energy, especially solar power, rainwater harvesting, and the other mitigative pollution control measures are in full swing. I am sure that the future coal production will enshrine the principle of the sustainable development with a special emphasis on ecological sustainability. I am highly hopeful that this event will bring about the plethora of ideas to ensure betterment of this industrial region of which all of us are the stakeholders. I congratulate Bengal Chamber of Commerce and Industries for organizing this event. Thank you.
We come to the end of the inaugural session. We're addressing the problems of commons, because this is all common property, it belongs to all of us, and that's why we don't know how to manage it. And of course, to end with coal, the ingredient, the basic ingredient for economic growth, especially in India today. And we cannot deny that the country is still going to need whatever coal we have to generate the power that is required for us to progress. And how we have, or we are undertaking, that we have, we'll have two more sessions. First one is on waste management, focusing on solid waste management and water waste treatment. We are going to talk about technology models. We are going to talk about best practices. And post lunch, we'll have industrial case studies on innovation and sustainability, which will be cases where we all can learn as to what are the better methods of. Before we conclude this session formally, we have to please present tokens of our deep appreciation to the speakers on the dais, to the chairman of WPCB, Dr. Polan Rudro, and to Sri Jay Prakash Gupta, Director Technical Eastern Coalfields Limited. Thank you. Just a very small. And including all the presentations. If you have got any query thereafter, please do connect with us. We will leave our mobile. That this is not the only occasion that we'll be interacting with you during this year, and that more opportunities will come our way in the when we change the DAS setting. Thank you very much. We'll be with you shortly.
Principal scientist, Satya Mojumdar, the right name at least. Satya is the right name now. Principal scientist, ceramic membrane division, CSIR, Central Glass and Ceramic Research Institute, Calcutta. Mr. Milan Mondal, who is the Divisional Forest Officer, Durgapur. Mr. Bhajinath Prasad, GM Environment, Eastern Coalfields Limited. And Mr. Jayadutta Mukherjee, Managing Director of GP Energy System, Private Limited. My one request to all the, they all have presentations. So my request is, if you could please finish your deliberation within 7-8 minutes, absolutely maximum. The reason is that I want to throw it for question. I'm sure many of you will have questions. If we don't finish it by 7-8 minutes each, that will be too much also. But even then, if you please finish it, look at your watch kindly and please finish it within 7-8 minutes. I will omit my introductory address, but I will only tell you that last year, 2017, on 8th February, there was a headline in Hindustan Times. The headline says, "Is India going to drown in its own waste?" And they gave an example of what is happening on that road from Delhi to Ghazipur. You can see birds of prey all around, then smoke, then heaps of garbage, rat pickups everywhere. In our country, an additional problem is that a population grows up, a habitat grows up around such things where garbage is collected. So we have even temples, we have markets around those garbage places in Gaza. So they were commenting on that this is something which is happening near Delhi. Many nations are going for zero waste. We have not reached that stage, as I told you earlier also. But at least one thing is very important, that before you do any treatment, any waste treatment, classification is very necessary. We have not been able to do it fully. Bangalore has tried a little bit, other cities taking it up. So this is something that has to be done. So kindly, if you take your discussions outside the hall, please take your discussion outside the hall. That is absolutely very, very important. Now, the technology is proceeding fast, and technology includes recycle, reuse, as I have mentioned. and the most revolutionary ideas from the very concept of waste to make it not a waste. And that is the whole idea. So I believe we will see some examples of the new technologies which are coming. And this session will actually convert waste to wealth and a cost center to a profit center, that you can make a business model.
Basically, I am hurriedly going through the introductory part. I represent CSIR, Central Mechanical Engineering Research Institute. We work on this cutting edge technology, but to be very concise, we are also working for society. We have Pakura and Birbhum. We work in Northeast. We are still in the Northeast. We have set up centers for post-service processing there. And now, we are into the waste management scenario. Before starting with this waste management scenario, which is the need of the hour, just let me show you a small video which focuses on the key areas that we are working on. An innovative solution to handle it in an eco-friendly way. CSIR CMARI has developed MSW treatment complex at its residential campus to make it a zero waste colony. The domestic waste collected from the colony contains organics and plastics with little amount of other inert materials. The waste requires judicious segregation before its treatment for disposal. In the mechanized segregation system developed by CSIR CMARI, metals, plastics and organics are separated. Generally, the waste materials from household are disposed of in plastic bags tied at the top. The bags are first dropped into a crusher, where the poly bags are tiered off and the materials comes out into the hopper.
This is the most important part, wherein lies our strength.
Hot air is passed over the waste materials so that the surface moisture is reduced substantially, which facilitate the further segregation process. In eddy current separator, the metallic parts are separated out. Subsequently, the waste materials are sent to air separation unit through conveyor. Plastics and biomass are being separated using high pressure air jet during gravity fall. Shankarpur,
this is the
dumping yard for MSW generated in Durgapur Municipal Corporation area. CSIR CMARI is continuously carrying out research work for the treatment of dead waste. It has been tested for the segregation and further treatment at CMARI Colony MSW complex. The waste is first put into a rotary sieve, where the already biodegraded fines are separated for utilization as manure.